But this next story here, another rapper that I have great appreciation for, and that's Meek Mill. He came out on Twitter and talked about his record deal. I'm going to go ahead and pull this up for you. So the article starts by saying Meek Mill wants every cent owed to him by his label. Less than a month after dropping his latest album, Expensive Pain, the Philly rapper took a not too subtle jab at the record label. He is currently signed to both Atlantic and Maybach Music Group, which is owned by rapper Rick Ross, for allegedly withholding money he is due. On Twitter, Meek wrote, "Ask the label, how much money have you spent on me as an artist? Then how much have you made off me as an artist? I'm about to make my record deal public by Monday just to let the world see what these people own." And today is Friday. He's definitely not released his record deal because he, you know, breach of contracts. All that's supposed to be confidential for the most part. So he can't just come out and give out the language in the contract. Pretty sure somebody hit him up and let him know you can't do that. That ain't gonna happen. Let's see if we got all the messages up here. Alright, so this next one has him saying, "I'm a wolf for everything that's mine, all ruthless vibes." I probably picked the wrong article to go to, because they definitely skipped over the first one. Let's see if we just go directly to Meek's Twitter. The tweet's still there. So looks like he deleted the original tweets where he talks about, "I've never made money off of my music." And for people who don't know how record deals work, rappers receive an advance. An advance is nothing but a loan. Any fees occurred by the artists, from marketing to logos to travel to food to hotel stays, is something they have to pay back. I don't know how much money they spent on Meek Mill, but a lot of rappers tend to realize they will never get out of the advance agreements that they have. Some rappers end up, you know, a little stuck in those deals. Yes, the label's going to make a lot of money off of you, but you have to recoup everything first. And then it goes into the splits and whatever you negotiated in your splits. I don't know what Meek deal could have been, but not surprising. It's a lot of rappers who come out and say they don't make money off their music. And then, you know, it comes down to how much money did you take in the advance to get you there? Because if you took a huge advance, then you can set yourself back if you don't make that money back. And I don't know what Meek took. Again, he did not show his contract. I would have loved to see his contract so we can go out there and compare it to other things that's out there. It would have been nice. But again, we don't know. So, I mean, yeah. Rick Ross then gave Meek, Wale, I feel like one of the best paths ever. It's, everywhere he went, he made sure to put on his artist. At least he tried to. He tried. He definitely tried. I don't know what happened with everybody else, but Meek and Wale definitely benefited from being on the Rick Ross. No lie about it. MMG was one of the hottest things moving for a period of time. Wale still drops hits. Meek's kind of lost his luster. The Drake thing definitely hurt him, but Championships was a hell of an album. Expensive Pain, not my favorite Meek project. Not my favorite Meek project. But it's Meek. So you always happy when you get some new Meek music. Of course, I'm always happy when I get some new Meek music. Hopefully, he can go find the lawyers he was tweeting about. Hopefully, he can go figure out what's in his deal. Because, I mean, you can audit the record label. I'm pretty sure you have the money to afford the lawyers when you're in the room with billionaires. That is one thing I do wonder. Like, if you're on Twitter, I mean, if you're around billionaires, why are you going to Twitter to ask Twitter questions when you have access to their research and their people and things of that such? I just think that'd be a little bit better use of your time instead of going to the people who, I mean, you're going to get a whole lot of different answers when it comes to people on the internet, but you know, you can get some more stuff done if you have access to the best lawyers, which I'm pretty sure Jay-Z and Robert Kraft and Roc Nation and all the other people that you know champion all the time, I'm pretty sure they have some of those connections. And you should use them. You should probably use them. You have Jay-Z there. He's making money off you too. You should probably use him. Pretty sure he'll help you figure out like what the hell is going on. Probably be good for you. Definitely will be good for you. It's your boy DJ the Park Boy, and I'm here with a special product for you. I got some Delta 8 weed from JK Distro, and I'm saying it's amazing. It's clean, smokable, and the best part is they deliver it right to your door. Because of the 2018 Farm Bill, it's now legal for them to have Delta 8 weed sent through the mail. That's right. And if you use promo code FLOSS1, you can get some clean, smokable weed sent to your door direct. You have options. You go right there to jkdistro.com. You look at all the strands they have, which is a lot. You can even get you some edibles. You can get you some wine. Anything in between you can think of. And you put in promo code FLOSS1, you're going to save you 20%. So go ahead, hop on that now. Make sure it's in the description.